Downstairs, John. Buddy, time to get up.
Hey, Dad.
Hey. Need something?
Yep, here we go.
You got a heavy date?
Nope, varsity match. Guy I'm wrestling is allergic to alcohol, so he uses Vaseline under his pits. I use aftershave.
The thrill of victory, the agony of aftershave.
Not touche.
Go for it.
Come on.
Listen, Dad, I wanted to talk to you about something, too.
You need money?
No. No, it's not money. Well, sort of in a way. It's about college.
You heard from Stanford? The wrestling scholarship came through?
No, I haven't heard anything.
Oh. Listen. Look, Dad, about Stanford, I really can't.
Hey, it's a great school, buddy. Really great. You know I wanted to go there, study law. But you get sidetracked. You get married, raise a family. Be right there! Here you go.
What's that for?
It's for being a rotten kid.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Come on, get out of here. I'm late. Talk to you later.
Listen, Mom, you gotta help me with that. I can't talk
to you. Buddy, we've been over this before. I hate the idea. I really do. I'm not getting into it with your father. It's your father.
What am I asking? Some time off. I mean, I just can't handle 4 more years right now. He'll be 90 instead of 18. Big deal.
Big deal. You'll put off college 1 year, then 2. Then you'll get a job. You'll make some money.
And wind up like Dad.
You're terrific, buddy. He wants something better for you than he had.
It's not what I mean. Stanford's outrageously expensive, and it hasn't been exactly raining money around here lately. I'm not even sure I want to be a lawyer. I don't know what I want to be. Anyway, it was his idea for me to go there. The guy changes, you know. He grows up.
You're so grown up. You talk to him.
Honey, have you seen my briefcase? Oh, there it is.
Coffee's still hot.
I got a listing waiting. Oh, I'll be late tonight. Dan's office party, remember?
Talk to your son. He has a problem.
I spoke to him this morning.
Not arm wrestling, Eddie. Talking.
I will, I promise. Got your wall-to-wall carpeting? Fine in the den, fully landscaped yard. There's a lot of bucks there. This is a nice house to raise kids. Great neighborhood.
Do you think they'd come down to 100,000?
Hey, it's tough. It's tough. Right now, you're both working. And then with a baby coming, it's going to be tough. But everybody deserves a house of their own. That's the American dream, right?
I think we can borrow most of the down payment, but it's the monthly payment that'll kill me.
Well, let's say that you make the down. You take out a short-term loan, you keep the payments low, And then later on, you get a better job. Forget it. Forget it. Those loans, they're a ripoff. They'll hit you with a balloon payment down the line and it'll break your back. Let me work on it. This house is right for you kids, and I want you in it.
I'm talking about the right attitude. Look at the Tad Force. Take a look at the record he's got. I mean, look at that. 3,750,000.
Thank you very much.
Numero uno. 3,750,000.
It's easy with a boss like you.
You know.
I want you to meet Charlie.
Hi, Charlie. How are you?
Good to see you.
You can't be number one forever.
Well, the kid's moving big money homes. I'm strictly a meat and potatoes man.
Well, we all know where that market went. The return of the 10% interest.
I'm into that. Excuse me now, Ronnie. Hey, Ronnie!
Eddie! How you doing?
I came down on my loan request, huh?
Oh, Eddie, come on. This is a party. Come on.
Are the kids going to clear the loan committee or not?
Eddie, they read out lousy. His gross income stinks. She's pregnant and out of a job in 3 months. I can't show that to the committee. Tell them to buy a mobile home. Come on, let's have a drink.
No, thanks. The loan came up sour. Now, don't get upset. There are other houses. I know. You had your heart set on that one, but we'll find something else. I'll hit the listings and I'll find something that's more affordable. Yeah. Oh, I'll call you soon. Yeah. All right. Yeah, sure. You bet. Take care.
Dan is looking for you. Oh, dear. Don't tell me. I know. You can't die.
I lost the last sale. Bottoms up.
Well, I think you're still the best salesman that Dan Hatton ever had. There, things are going to pick up.
I needed that last closing. And those poor kids, honestly. Hey, why should I make myself crazy?
Toot. What's the matter? Stop looking at me like I'm some kind of an axe murderer. Really, it's okay. Everybody's doing it. Anyway, it's Friday, so come on.
I'm a Scotchman.
Well, that'll rot your liver, that's for sure. See? No Looney Tunes. Still smiling, okay?
Why do you do that stuff?
Same reason you drink and I don't. Makes me feel good. You want to dance?
Let's go, Hotshot. The Emperor's about to make his speech.
As a lot of you know, TransAllied Properties has been talking to me about an acquisition merger. On Wednesday this week, I put the old John Hancock on the papers, and I can officially welcome you to the West Coast office of TransAllied Properties Incorporated, Daniel H. Hatton, President!
Okay! Yeah.
He didn't tell you, did he?
Hey, kiddo!
Oh, come on, now, you knew we were talking.
You promised me, Dan. Had three people when I first came here. You got 50.
And you helped put him here. Now, come on, this is Dano. I'll take care of you, haven't I?
Really? Always... Well, where's my partnership? I don't see my name up there.
Well, it's a corporate buyout, Eddie. Even my name isn't up there.
I thought you were my friend.
Hey.
do that to me. What are you doing home so early?
When you invite him in.
For your information, that was your son. I went to the movies with him and Howie. Now don't you feel dumb? Honey. Yoo-hoo.
Hey, come on, come on.
Eddie, I'm flattered that you're jealous. Hey, don't be that way. What's the matter with you?
Going to bed. Hey, why don't you try tying the key to your belt the next time, huh, Junior?
Hey, come on. Hey, Eddie, come on. We're both bros. Hey, I owe you one, okay, Eddie?
Forget it.
Oh. Come on in, Eddie. Gotta check this place out, you know? So how you like it, Eddie?
What were you in before, cars?
Motor yachts, actually.
You don't like selling houses.
I like making money. You ought to try it, Eddie. Lose some weight, huh? Get yourself some clothes. No, Eddie, you're very good at selling crackers. They're boxes. But when it comes to luxury homes, you just don't know the market.
You're a snob.
Absolutely. And I intend to be a very rich snob. You don't mind going out the back way, do you, Eddie?
You think you're going,
Dan, I just got a call.
Oh, Eddie, I'm in a meeting. One of my salesmen, Eddie Gant.
Why don't I talk to you later, Dan? Nice meeting both of you.
Hey, kiddo.
Hey, what the hell is going on? A year ago, we were talking partnership. All of a sudden, I'm one of your lousy salesmen.
Well, they're new to me, Eddie. Now, give me some time. I'll bring you up, I promise.
I'm on a luxury listing.
Now, why rock the boat? In a few months, things will loosen up. Mid-range buyers will come
home. Oh, hell with mid-range buyers. You've got an ex-boat salesman out there that's not yet dry behind the ears. He's leading the pack. I want in, Dan.
Eddie, stay with what you know.
I
please.
I was number one for 10 years. I brought the best people in here. I trained them. I did it. You owe me for that, Dan.
Tad's been coming up cold on one of my exclusives. I'll flop it over to you.
You going to let it out or what?
No, it's something at the office. Business. It has nothing to do with you.
I'm in the line of fire.
Well, honey, who am I going to yell at? The lady next door? Hmm?
Dan sold out. Transallied. Everybody's nervous.
You knew that was coming?
Well, you know a train is coming, too, but you don't think it's going to hit you. I asked for a luxury listing.
And Dan agreed?
I would have walked, and he knew it.
Isn't your kind of market, is it?
You too, huh? Family housing is a graveyard. We're living on savings for 6 months, and my own wife doesn't think that I can handle a new market? Well, look, I've got news for you. Just understand this, honey. Selling is selling.
Eddie, don't talk to me like I'm a child. You've always been a salesman. We've had good years and bad years.
Never like it is now, never. Not where I am in my life.
We're not exactly on food stamps. We'll survive.
Great. We'll survive. Why don't you tell that to the bank when our house payment comes due, huh? Just tell them we're surviving. Or tell Stanford we're surviving. And we'll owe him Buddy's tuition.
Well, that's one off your shoulders because your son has decided he doesn't want to go to Stanford.
When did he decide that?
He's been working up his courage to talk to you. He wants to take a year off. Find himself or something.
Find himself.
Kids.
Buddy isn't you. He doesn't want the same things.
Please, come on. Subject of Buddy is closed. It's closed.
You like the hand? Take a picture.
Numbers are my life.
Numbers are his life. How many times you take the CPA test?
They don't kill you for trying. Right, Eddie?
I'm sorry, what did you say, Zach?
The guy's got a right not to give up, no matter how old he is, right?
We're playing poker or doing career testing. Come on, it's a half to you.
Where are my hands at?
How can one guy go to the bathroom so many times in a night? What's he got, a girl in there? Okay. Zachary takes, Morty takes three. Oh, Theo takes one.
All right.
I'm out.
Hey, come on, you got two pair there. What are you doing, taking arithmetic lessons from Zachary?
Counting takes more brains than pedal pushing.
I'm a dealership. I sell quality bicycles.
Okay, suckers, what's happening? We playing? We playing here?
No, it's the bets to you.
All right. Oh, look at that pot. God save me from accountants playing my hand. I raise.
Fold.
Come on. Pair of kings, I win, and you lose.
Hey, come on, what are you doing, Morty?
Come on,
hey,
deal. Come on,
it's my deal.
Listen, I hate to be a wet blanket, but let's call it. I'm beat.
Oh, come here. On, you guys, yeah. I'm getting hot here.
Hey, I'll keep the
test. You just do it, okay? Do it!
Yeah.
One round of killer, winner take all. Come on.
Oh, come on. Gotta work tomorrow. Open early.
Come on, we used to play all night here.
Yeah, well, look, some of us still got wives. We gotta go home
to the
morning.
Hey, put a lid on it, huh, Stewie?
Hey, you guys miss you going home to what I got waiting to happen.
Hey, next week.
Okay, so long,
Al. All right, open up.
Oh, what day?
Come on, open up or I'm gonna break your neck. Oh, damn, I do good work. Huh? What is it, Eddie? I know you 18 years, man and dentist. You got a crisis. I can see it in your teeth. Look at him. He's smiling. What is it, you and Barbara? Come on, get out of the house. Chaco, there's a world out there. Look at me, huh? Better than I was at 20. Oh, give me a shot. Give me a shot right here. Huh? Come 17 on. Pounds I lost since I met Jackie.
Come on. Get out of it. Go home, you va-va-va-boom.
I reverse the aging process. He makes fun.
Come on.
Stewie!
Come on.
Let's
get some bread.
Later. Will you later?
Buddy, come on.
Hey, Morty, what's happening?
Come on. Come on. We got to go dancing.
Come on. I just wrestled.
What's wrong with
Morty?
You?
Morty, go home. I'm dying.
Come on.
What kind of drugs are you feeding Dr. Morris?
Too much beer.
Yeah? No way.
So how was your match? Win?
Guys are wimps. We killed them.
Tell me, you're going to be home on the weekend?
No, water skiing. How these folks went into Hawk and bought a condo. Seems really dumb on his old man's salary.
What is it with you kids, huh? Why are you always down on what parents do? You know, we break our backs to make life a little bit better for you. All you can do is moan about how dumb we are.
Just told you about Stanford the year off, right?
Why don't you want to go to college?
I'm just asking for some time off to find out what I want to do. I mean, I just spent 12 straight years in school, and now everyone expects me to keep up the steamroller and be some kind of lawyer or something. I don't even like law.
You said you did. We used to talk about it.
I was 14, Dad. Come on.
So be anything that you want. What is wrong with going to the best college?
Nothing. If you can afford it.
What is it with everybody all of a sudden? You don't think that I can afford it? Huh? You're talking to me. I built that office from the ground up. I was number one on the charts for 10 years running. 10. Every 2 years, a new car. Who the hell does he think he is? Calling me one of his salesmen.
What are you talking about?
The issue is closed. You're going to Stanford. You can study walls. You're going.
Why are we doing this, honey? You know you hate Dan's house parties.
I'm supposed to meet the luxury market buyers. I build Dan's business. He buys the big beach house.
Selling fancy homes to big buyers? This isn't you.
I'll change my image.
Hey, Eddie. Hello, sweetheart. How are you? Listen, hey, didn't I tell you it was casual? Hi, Barbie, sweetheart. How are you? Listen, mingle, have a drink. The bar's up there. I'll be around. Hey, Eddie, eyes open. Some hot listings here.
How's he managed to make me feel so unwelcome, even when he's kissing me?
Hi. We've got a step meeting like this. You know Bruce Newman, don't you, Eddie?
Commerce Bank, loan department.
Oh, yeah, sure. How you doing?
Great. Terrific.
You look uncomfortable.
Well, nobody told me it was a swim party.
Oh, these people are barracudas. They cruise in packs, and they eat outsiders, so watch it.
Do me a favor, kiddo. Don't embarrass yourself. Come on. Come on, this is business. Let them get sloshed if they want to. You need your eyes and your ears to sense the deal. I shouldn't have to tell you that.
Fine, I'll go wash my face on you.
That's the Eddie I know and love. Hey, Ted! Ted, come here. I want you to meet up. Mind if I just wash up?
No, come on in.
Thank you. Ralph, I'm telling me about you. Thinks you're a terrific guy, great salesman.
Oh, I appreciate that.
Says you're in trouble in a dead market.
I'll dig out.
You know, I used to be a lot like you. A lot of big money customers to handle and found out they were handling me. I learned to listen, make myself receptive. Never push. I gain their trust, they give me their business. It's simple. I've been watching you. Kind of like a student of people. You're afraid of this crowd. So you shove yourself in a corner and get quietly smashed. You never sell them unless you're one of them. Now, go ahead. Everybody needs a boost once in a while. It's not addictive.
No, I tried grass once. It just made me dizzy.
This won't make you feel anything but on top of things and control.
No, thanks.
Suit yourself. You know, I may be speaking out of turn, but when you find something that makes life easier, I say go for it. What do you think makes Tad work 16 hours a day?
That stuff, it doesn't make you act crazy or anything.
Do I seem crazy?
How do you do it?
Just like I did.
I feel like an idiot.
Now the other side. You can breathe, Eddie. It's not grass.
So, what do I do now?
Now you go out and enjoy.
Thank you.
signaling the cheerleader in the bikini?
Barb, we ought to think about moving to the beach. Terrific traffic flow, kitchen to the sand in one motion. We'd get a house moving, move the place down to a beach lot, put up a volleyball court. It'd be terrific, really, really.
You're not driving home. Cocky's
please. Hey, I feel fine. I feel great. Hi there. Nice party. Good to see you again.
You know her?
Never saw her before in my life. I'll be a minute. Hey, Daniel.
Hey.
Daniel.
All right.
Hey, I'm glad to...
Hey, Malcolm! Oh, what's your name, Ted?
Hi.
Hey, Charlie, come in.
Eddie, you reading my notes on Marché?
Yeah, Frenchman. Investments or something.
Not or something. Did you call him personally?
He's in Europe. His wife's going to be there. Look, I've been down the pike a few times.
Eddie, they're not buying three in a den. These people demand special treatment.
So what do you want me to do, sleep with a lady?
If that's what it takes. Hey, loosen up. They'll love you.
How do you do? I'm Eddie Gant, Hatton Realty.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Lean Poe, and I will interpret for Madame Marché.
How do you do?
Que pensez-vous, madame?
As you can see, the room is quite large. Very nice for entertaining, for parties. I tell you, they don't make them like this anymore. And the dining room. Oh, I want to show you the kitchen. It's just been remodeled. It's one of the nicest...
I'm not interested in the kitchen. The kitchen's for servants, and Madame Marché does not go into the kitchen.
The terrace is very lovely. It opens out from the dining room, as you can see, on one of the most beautiful views that you... hello? Hello? The view is quite lovely.
Hi there, sailor. You new in town?
Oh, hey, Robin. How's it going?
Oh, same old grind. Tad said today was your big day. How did it go?
Definite callback.
Well, that's fabulous. No. It was a real stinker, huh?
Yeah, Murphy's Law. Everything that could go wrong did.
Well, the luxury market's different. But you're a quick study. You'll get into it. Eddie, look, we've been friends for over 5 years. Anytime you want to talk over your problems, you just give me a call. You can come over tonight if you like. I'm a great listener.
Hey, I can handle it. It's...
For friend in need, you know? It's no burden. Here's my address. Now, don't be shy.
Barbara Gant.
Yeah.
Hi, Eddie. How did it go?
Fine.
I'm so happy for you.
Anyway, she loved the house. She really loved it. Listen, why don't we grab a steak after work? Just the two of us.
Oh, honey, I'm not even going to get home for dinner. I'm loaded here.
How about a rain check for tomorrow?
Tomorrow? What? Yeah, it's terrific.
Listen, are you okay? You sound funny.
No, I'm great. I'm great. I'll talk to you later.
Okay, honey.
I called Barbara to go to dinner, but that poor girl, she's up to her neck in work.
I won't tell Eddie, promise.
How about a drink?
Nothing for me.
Well, sit down and take a load off. Rob tells me he didn't do so well first time out.
That's an understatement. I bombed.
Well, it takes a certain finesse. I mean, not that I think you can't develop it. Tad had his problems in the beginning, too. I helped him put some leads together.
I think I'll have a scotch.
Sure thing. Nice?
Neat.
Okay. You know, we ought to get together for lunch sometime. I'm always getting leads in the loan department. When you get rolling, you make the deals, I'll make the loan.
Sounds great. Thank you. I really think I'll leave you two alone.
Oh, you sound like the Ancient Mariner. I mean, everyone blows his sail once in a while. Just give it some time.
Time's not on my side.
You listen to him? Time isn't on my side. I saw you at Dan's. I mean, you didn't look like a guy ready for the unemployment line. How about something light, hmm? Who's for stir fry?
You cut the bok choy, I'll make the appetizer.
You got it.
Made a fair-sized buy from a friend. I let a little out here, a little there. Good customers at the bank, like Tad. People I trust, you understand? This stuff's like a commodity in some circles. Better than money sometimes. I don't deal or anything. Whatever it costs me, I get it back. So my profit comes from maintaining a good business relationship.
It's really expensive, isn't it?
Yeah, very. But the movers and shakers don't care. They're too busy making money. I go a couple times a week, tops. Purely recreational. I can afford it.
Thank you, kind sir.
Shrinks are on the fifth floor. Two?
Why don't you let him be flip with you? Because Bruce knows this market real well. I mean, all you've got to do is get with the energy flow. And those people can smell desperation a mile off. I mean, everybody's into one-upmanship, bigger house, fancier car, be somebody, do something. It's all a game. I mean, all you got to do is learn how to play it.
You see, there are the watchers and the doers. The watchers watch the doers do and wonder why they can't scrape together the price of a ticket. That booze is gonna kill you, Eddie. I had this friend, four drinks zip right over the La Jolla Cliffs. Guy's got broccoli for brains. Am I right, Rob? Booze will kill you.
Yeah, every time.
You mind if I...
You kidding? That's what it's for.
Fix my speakers.
Hey, why don't we call a truce, huh? Listen, I got this thing all figured out. You forget college for now. You take 2 years in the Army. They train you at whatever. You get paid. You add that money to the college fund. You come out. You're older, wiser. You travel. They send you to Germany, Japan, wherever. You learn a language. You learn a trade. You take on anything you want, huh? Huh?
Join the Army. You're serious.
Well, of course I'm serious. You get out in the world, you get your head on straight, you make some really good moves for a change. Really good moves. I mean, you like the physical stuff, don't you? Huh? Huh? Well, you march around, you run a few miles, basic training, you feel great, really great. What do you want to go all over the country for, running here and running there? In the Army, you do something that's constructive. What do you think?
I think it sucks.
Sucks? Huh? Best idea I ever had, and you said sucks?
Really bad.
You did say that, didn't you? You said you did. Don't let go of it. It's a good idea. You think about it.
That was beginning to worry.
I stopped for a couple of drinks.
Listen, you hungry? You want a sandwich?
No, I'm gonna take off a couple of pounds.
Eddie, what are you doing?
You know, we ought to rearrange these shelves. The access is all wrong. The glasses should be over here by the sink. You got the spices here. That doesn't really make any sense.
Two drinks and use the white tornado.
Yeah, I love it when you're in your sexy work clothes.
Eddie, I've had this skirt since Buddy was in junior high.
Yeah, and you look so good in it. I love it.
Oh, boy. Chinese lady must have made an offer.
No. I just got my act together. Eddie Gant's going to be a killer out there. Going to be a killer. Oh, show's on.
Hey, what's with him?
I don't know. Must have had a good day. Said he stopped for a few drinks.
Bizarre parental behavior.
Uh-huh. Eddie?
Yeah?
Let me in.
Just a minute.
When did you start locking the door?
I didn't know it was locked.
Catching a cold?
Allergies.
What are you looking at?
Not a pretty woman.
Percy. Hmm? Percy.
Hmm?
Second time tonight you made me a lewd offer.
If I can't make a lewd offer to you, who can I make a lewd offer to? Hmm?
Now that is an incredibly view. Absolutely incredible. And it can be enjoyed from every room in the house. You notice how the living area here flows right out into the deck in one graceful sweep. Real indoor-outdoor living. It's really spectacular. Didn't recognize you with your tupon.
I don't wear it much.
Rhoda giving you a bad time about the support payments? Pulled the wrong tooth, somebody suing you?
No, I'm just I'm a little depressed, that's all. I'm sleeping lousy, you know. I'm just getting old.
Oh,
come on. Everybody gets old, but not my old buddy Mort, the original go-get-em kid. Hey, come on.
8 months and she walks out. 1 minute she's there. And now I got empty closets.
You mean Vavoom?
Jackie. Look at me. Look at me. Eddie, who am I going to attract at my age?
Hey, Mort, she was just a kid.
I couldn't keep up with her. I tried. I worked 10, 12 hours a day, and I had to party with Jackie.
Well, maybe you need to see a doctor.
I am a doctor, you jackass.
Hey, you know what I mean.
Eddie, listen to me. I'm losing everything. My practice is going to hell. I'm spending money like it was water.
You need money? You want
no,
to
no, 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 no. It's not money, Eddie. Please,
hey,
listen
hey,
to
hey,
me.
Hey, wait. Hold that thought, will you? A friend of mine just came in. Order me a scotch.
Wait. Where are you going?
Hey, you're looking great. You dropped a couple of inches, huh?
Working on it? How do we do this?
This isn't a mafia meeting. Did you put the money in an envelope? You give me that. And I give you this.
Seems like an awful little bit for $350.
Good quality. Oh, give me a call on Thursday. I got a line on a couple of prospects.
Hey, Morty, what are you doing?
No, you're busy. I'll catch you later.
Hey, no. Sit down. We'll talk.
Talk's not going to do it for me anymore, Eddie.
Not too dark, huh? I don't want to look unnatural.
Excuse me, but my husband left the house this Saturday morning, and now this other guy shows up in his Cadillac and leather jacket.
Come on, get in. I'll take you for a ride.
Hey, what's going on? We can't afford a car like this.
Hey, honey, I got a good buy. Sassonian went into escrow. I'm good for $20,000. Well, $20,000.
That's fine. But shouldn't we have talked about this? I mean, a new car. This
oh,
whole transformation.
Come on, honey, don't ruin it for me. I mean, just don't ruin it. I want to enjoy a few things while I still can. I'm not going to be a 47-year-old loser.
You're not a loser, Eddie. You don't have to prove anything.
I'm not trying to prove anything. You want to go for a lousy ride or not?
Yeah, I want to go for a lousy ride. You don't mind the lousy dirt on your clean seats?
Get in the lousy car. kidding. I thought it was midnight. Hey, Barb, you know that old beat-up Spanish style next to the bar listing? I could get the owner to take back a land lease. We could go in there with a bulldozer, clear the place. We'd have a 5-acre lot. We could make a profit of $200,000 easy. Real easy.
Look what time it is. Hey. Come to bed. Stop it.
Got him this time. The games that you can play in six figures. I mean, the money that's in this town. It's incredible.
Eddie, I'm worried about you. I know you love what you're doing, and everything is going so well for you, but we never see you. You're up till all hours. You're sleeping late. Maybe it's hypertension. I want you to call Dr. Marvelin.
Honey, there is nothing. I'm fine. I mean, I just got these deals whizzing around in my head. That's all.
Lately, everything moves at double time
lately,
for you.
Lately. It's always lately. Barbara, there is nothing that is wrong with me. I'm fine.
That is exactly what I'm talking about. Who could that be at this hour? Hello? Rhoda? No, it's okay. What's wrong? Oh, my God. When? Well, how? How did it happen?
Is it the kids?
No. Do you want us to come over? No. If you need anything, you call us. Eddie will find him. I'm sure he'll be fine. Okay, honey. Bye.
What is it?
Mort Broom tried to commit suicide.
Morty did what?
He used a hunting rifle, then. Bullet went through his collarbone.
I can't believe it. I mean, I saw him, what? It was just a few weeks ago. I mean, he seemed like he was a little bit down. But Jackie, that kid that was... I mean, she took off on him, but... I mean, Morty's just not the kind of a guy.
What kind of a person tries to kill himself with a hunting rifle?
Hey, Morty. Tooth Fairy told me to tell you you're putting her out of work.
How you doing, kid?
Oh, I'm great. I'm fine. I like getting out of the house, driving 200 miles without sleep. So what happened, Morty?
I missed.
Hey, why didn't you tell me? I was sat with you, got drunk with you, whatever. I mean, this is just crazy, that's all. Hey, you listen to me, Morty. Whatever you need, place to stay, talk, you got it, you understand? Because you're going to be all right, you're going to be fine.
Listen to me. Don't talk, just listen. I've been doing very bad things. Cocaine, a lot of it. I want you to go home now. I'm okay. It's a place I can go. It'll take some time, but I can beat it.
Hey, I don't believe it. I mean, it's not that dangerous. You know, people are taking this stuff all over the place. You sure this is not depression or something?
Not now, Eddie. I'm
Jack Traylor. Hi. Eddie, it's a pleasure. Come on board. Hope you didn't have any trouble finding us.
Couldn't miss it.
Eddie, I'd like to have you meet my wife, Tony.
How
Eddie?
Are you?
Sit down, sit down.
Thank you.
Bruce says you're absolutely fabulous at finding great progress.
Eddie's got a talented nose. Oh, we sail down several times a year to see Tony's mother. We'd like something near the marina, say about 700,000.
700? Hey, that's terrific. Marina's a great place. Water, boats. Tony, I bet you like to cook, huh? Glass and wood, architect design, huh? Huh? Am I right?
He's absolutely psychic. Isn't he psychic, Jack?
Eddie, how about some wine?
Sure.
Bruce, stay aboard. Enjoy the air.
Thank you again.
Oh, my pleasure.
Ciao.
Good to see you. Chick. Here, it's $10 million. Can't add two and two.
Tough life, huh?
Yeah. Well, thanks for the lead. That's another one I owe you.
Oh. El Supremo. Peru to you. A friend of mine is holding almost a pound. I'm taking 5 ounces on consignment.
No, thanks. You're giving me these headaches.
Washing your nose out?
Not as much as I should.
Not yet.
Try using one of these. You want crystals hanging around in your septum. But it's an ounce or nothing. I can't take the risk of having that much stuff laying around my apartment. I got people lining up for this. 2,800 the ounce.
Oh, come on, Bruce. Don't make it the national debt. I don't mind a gram once in a while just for recreational purposes. But, you know, it's not really a serious thing with me. Just something to get me over the hump.
Sure, I know. But you got to treat it like paper towels. It goes on sale. You buy in quantity.
It's a Sony of mine. That's in T-bills. I got an escrow closing in 2 weeks, huh?
I can't hold it for you, Eddie. And I don't want you to do anything that you don't want to do. I'm just trying to be your friend.
I'll replace some money in 2 weeks. If it's that good, it'll last twice as long, huh?
Right, you're right.
That's a forfeit of 90 days' interest, Mr. Gant.
Yeah, I'll replace the money in a couple of weeks.
Well, our rates may go down.
So, what is it, your money?
Your money or your wife?
Hey, Eddie. Hey, you look great. How's the arm?
Oh, I look like hell.
The arm's fine. This thing comes off next week. I'm getting through it, you know.
Jackie thing finished?
Yeah. Probably boogalooing around the world. Look, Eddie, I want to get together with you. I want you to know what happened up there. I've been a very foolish man. Oh, all right. I know. It's okay. A lot of people feel strange when they know someone's a druggie.
Oh, that's a stupid word, Mort. You fell for a chippy. She turned your head. I understand that. Everybody does.
See, I tried to blame Jackie, but she was just the tip of the iceberg. It was me. It was me all the way. Look, I'm seeing a shrink here in the building, but please, we'll get together, we'll talk.
Hey, yeah, anytime, night or day, we never close.
Terrific. I don't want to get personal, but you got something going on the side here?
What are you talking about?
What am I talking about? Look at this bankroll.
An escrow fell through. What's all the questions for? What do you know what I do for a living?
Hey, Jocko, I'm only kidding.
Yeah, well, I get a little uncomfortable with all this, this cash. I'll talk to you later, Morty.
Some
suntan lotion. We're going to the beach.
I gave you money, buy your own.
Okay, sorry.
I just don't like you coming in here and borrowing things.
Okay,
without
I'm
asking.
Sorry.
You going to the beach or not?
Is everything okay? I mean, with you and Mom?
Yeah, everything's fine.
Have I done something to tick you off? I mean, no one can talk to you lately. If it's me, I want to know so I can keep doing it. Joke, Dad.
Buddy, I've got a king-size headache. I'm late. You're missing 4-foot waves at La Jolla. I gave you a large sum of money. Don't tell me in a couple of days. It's been over 2 weeks now. I can't afford to run out of steam. Well, of course I can do without it. It's just that everything is coming down on me. That's not the point. I gave you the money. Tonight? Well, why didn't you say so? I'll talk to you later.
Daddy, you see the tote board? The Markley deal put you over the top. You're the new numero uno.
Yeah, so you thought you'd come around and congratulate the old man, huh?
No, come on, Eddie. I'm being up front with you.
And who do you think is standing in the wings waiting for me to fall in my face?
Hey, come on, Eddie. I know what you and Bruce are into. Listen, you better ease off and get to a doctor fast.
You're the one that better see a doctor.
When I get through with you, there's going to be nothing left. Can you believe that guy?
It just goes against my grain.
Are you getting what you want for nothing? Am I? What do you think, Eddie goes home and weighs this?
I don't like you turning him on to so much at one time. He doesn't understand what he's getting into. He's not handling it.
Come on, Rob, he's handling. Put him on to 8 solid lead, he brings home 4. You know what kind of record that is?
I want you to tell him that your sore's dried up. I don't care, you just tell him anything. He's not a casual tutor. He's into it too heavily, he's doing too much, and it's costing him a fortune with you.
Believe me, he can afford it. When he wants to stop, he'll stop.
You sound just like a dealer.
Don't you ever call me that. I am a businessman, and this is part of doing business. Grow up, okay?
Can I get you something?
No, hungry.
Better late than never.
Seems like so little for so much.
Gets the job done. It's top quality. Well, I gotta hit the road.
Stay and have a taste?
No, I'll take a rain check.
Can I get you something? You're getting so thin.
No, you want a hit?
Let's not, huh? I mean, you can overdo a good thing.
Sound like a wife. Good dude.
Chinese, and you had him run around trying to show him that.
I was trying to describe romantic dinners on the veranda. They were running around jabbering like I was the invisible man. Nice hair.
Oh, I like you very much. You're a nice man. You're my friend.
But I'm married.
Yes, you're very married.
And right now I'm very loaded.
Yes.
True.
kitchen. I'm gonna make us a salad.
Hey, Rob, I'm not fussing you. It's just that my wife isn't into this stuff. Two people on the same wavelength, that could be spectacular.
You're a very sweet man, Eddie. You really are. But it's not love, it's the drugs. There's a big difference, believe me.
Hey.
No, I want you to promise me that this is going to be the last time that you have any dealings with Bruce again. I want you to promise me that.
Hey, the rough spots are almost over. A couple of months, I'll slow down, okay? I don't really need it.
Good night, Eddie Gant.
Come on, Eddie, in or out? You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Deal me out. I gotta go to John.
Between these two guys, you could lower the water table of Greater San Diego.
$5 says Eddie will make an even 9 visits before 10:30.
Hey, where the heck's everybody going?
No, I'm going to my car to get some dental floss. I got popcorn in my teeth.
Yeah, pick a car.
Any car. Go ahead.
Hey, Marty. Next.
How much you doing?
Doing? I went to the bathroom.
You're buzzing so loud I can hear you.
Hey, I got a little urinary infection, you know. Doctor gave me some pills.
Sure, yeah, but you got allergies. You got head colds. You're taking diuretics. Come on, Eddie. I've used all those excuses. I've used some you haven't heard of.
Well, what you talking about?
You don't, huh? Wait, you think I don't know what's going on, Eddie? I was writing prescriptions for pharmaceutical cocaine. I was hitting 10, 15 times a day with Jackie, without Jackie. Patients complained. They thought I was rambling. Well, I thought they were crazy, Eddie, because I was incredible. I mean, I was 20 years old again, all 8 cylinders, you know, just
clicking. Hey, look, Morty, let me
listen to me, you idiot. You know what I did up there? I locked myself up in a room, and I smoked Freebase 30, 40 hours at a stretch. There was no sleep, no thinking, no nothing. I didn't want Jackie, I didn't want my kids, I didn't want my ex-wife, I didn't want anything. I wanted cocaine. You want to wind up like me?
Come on. Morty, I'm not into it that heavy. I feel great.
Ed, you feel great. You always feel great in the beginning. I tried to kill myself. Me, Mr. Middle Class, I had my stupid toe on the trigger of a rifle. Eddie, it gives so much, but it takes, and it takes, and it takes! How about your nose? Soreness? Bleeding?
So my nose is a little sore. I don't wash it like I should.
Barber, no? A buddy? You figure it out? Good. How you doing with them? You uptight? You paranoid? You short-tempered? Hey, Eddie, how's your sex life? How's that going?
Hey, that's one thing about coke. Oh,
hey, I mean the Superman syndrome. Eddie, 3 weeks I couldn't touch Jackie. She didn't leave me. I pushed her out. Don't you get it? I loved it. I loved it, Eddie. It was all I could think about. And I still think about it. So much I want to scream. Eddie, it'll kill you.
Why don't you tell me what's right for me? I'm not you. I'm not some kind of an addict. I'm a husband. I'm a father. I provide for my family. I didn't leave them. Shack up with some bimbo. What do you think I am anyway?
Drug abuser, just like me.
Hey, we playing poker here or not? Who's dealing?
going to bed. It's late. I found a letter in Buddy's drawer. I was putting his socks away. It was a letter of acceptance from Stanford. 3 weeks old.
He's 18. He can mess up his own life if he wants to.
You sound like you're just riding Buddy
off. Oh, no, it's my fault.
It's nobody's fault. Buddy just needs room, time to grow up. You're really tired. Oh, let him wake up. Buddy? Oh.
Come on, cut it out.
Can't get you going in the morning. Obviously, at night either.
What's that supposed to mean?
I kind of liked it when it was gray. When are we going to talk about the insane schedule you're keeping? About Buddy? About anything that doesn't have to do with selling houses and making money.
If you don't like the money, don't spend it.
I hear you say money one more time, Eddie. So help me, I'll scream. Honey, I want you to see a doctor. I need some answers, Eddie, and so do you.
We don't make love for a couple of days, and you got me ready for the funny farm.
I didn't say that. But now that you've brought it up, your couple of days has been over 3 weeks. Is it me? Is there another woman?
Going up, going up. Okay. Didn't I tell you it was too worried?
You've got a new company now. We're going straight up.
Hey, Eddie, wait a minute.
Hey, the corporate boys are really aware of you. It's not final, but they need a guy to take over the L.A. operation. Now, it's between you and Tad, boss. I'm pushing for you.
That's great.
I hand a guy Beverly Hills and Bel Air, and all he can say is it's great.
Oh, these damn sinuses are killing me. No, it's terrific. It's terrific.
Well, look, they'll be here in 20 minutes. Now, take something for the sinuses.
Yeah.
I told you to hold the calls.
Post time, killer. Let's go eat him alive.
Now, we know that the L.A. market is not all that different, right? Just a little more glitter. They want first-class treatment, that's all. I can show twice as many listings in half the time. Half the time. I put the method together down here. It'll be twice as effective up there. Twice as effective. What are you looking at? You think I can't cut it? You think I'm not telling the truth? It'll be twice as effective up there. You think
I... Eddie, it's bleeding. Your nose. I'm sure Eddie didn't realize.
Hey! Don't tell me I didn't realize. It's infected. Anybody will tell you that. Any doctor will tell you that. It could happen to anybody. What the hell are you looking at?
Anyway, step outside with me for just 1 minute, please. Step outside.
What's the matter with those people, Dan? They've never seen nosebleed before. Are they in this business or not? I've tested it. I can do twice as many listings in half the time. You know that. You've seen me.
I heard what happened between you and Tad in the hallway. I let it go. Now, I don't know whether it's head trips or drinking or what, but you're not screwing me up on this deal. As far as I'm concerned, we're even.
Oh,
you got a problem, pal. Solve it or you're out.
What are you doing, Al?
Contrary to popular opinion, I live here.
Yeah, we haven't seen you for dinner now. You okay? Lousy.
I'm fine. What's with her? It's not a her, that's your mother.
Excuse me.
I don't go through your things. I was going to wash your sweatshirt, and I found it in the pocket. I don't want to know what it is, and I don't want to know where you got it. I just want it out of here.
You going to tell us where you got it? Do I have to smack you in the mouth to find out? You think that you're too big for me?
I don't want to know.
You're an athlete. Why do you mess yourself up with dope?
He's holding it for a friend.
I don't want to hear this. I don't want to know if he's lying or not. I just want it out of this house.
So who's your friend, Howie? Hmm? What the hell is the matter with you? You know what that stuff can do to you?
You should know.
What does that mean?
It's yours. From the shaver case. Really something, you know? Big hotshot salesman. Drives a Cadillac with a telephone.
That's enough, buddy.
Yeah. You know what you're doing? Shoving that junk up your nose? And they teach us about it in junior high now. Like they cut this stuff with speed, lidocaine.
Keep your voice down, please.
Oh, sure. Let's whisper, because Dad's got a drug problem, and we don't want to talk about it. But let it be Buddy and everyone's screaming.
mean, after all, his old man's an upstanding citizen. I mean, you're setting an example for me, right?
Please, buddy.
Did you think I was going to really use that garbage?
I missed it.
I mean, I figured Morty's hitting on somebody, but you, I mean, I find this stuff in your shaver case. I couldn't believe it. I mean, who am I going to talk to? God, you had enough stuff there to stone out the basketball team for a month. You're pathetic.
Eddie, it's after... Oh, no work today?
No, I decided to take a couple of days off.
Thank God. You've been going 100 miles an hour. Listen, Eddie, when can we talk about, Buddy, this whole thing with the drugs?
Oh, it belonged to a friend of his. I checked.
It still worries me. Aren't you going to eat something?
No, I'm late.
I don't know who to worry more about, you or him. See you tonight.
Hello? Oh, Bruce. No, I'm fine. I'm just taking a few days off, that's all. Braylor's? When? Today? Oh, hey, forget it. No, forget it. I tell you, Bruce, my sinuses, they're really messed up. They're just really giving me fits. Well, tell him that I'll see him some other time. Well, how the hell do I know when?
Three more days you can pig out for the rest of the year. Dance! You move like an old lady. Come on, pick him up, pick him up.
Yeah? Well, I don't. Quit.
Cold. I won't buy any more. I won't take any more, even if it's offered to
me. I've heard that one before. Well, you're so pretty white.
Big jock, you never drink, never does anything out of line?
Never said I didn't do anything. There's more drugs around the school campus than you can find out on the street. You have to be from outer space to avoid it. I don't do drugs because I made the choice not to.
Oh, buddy, please. Understand, I was under incredible pressure to perform. Incredible. I had to get my name on the board. You've got to score. You know that. You've got to score. You've got to...
What the hell do you want from me? You want me to tell you that it's all right, that I don't care what happens to you? What am I saying? You're supposed to tell me. You're supposed to be the father.
Dad,
I want to talk to you.
No, I don't want to argue, buddy.
I don't know what to do for you. I've seen guys get strung out, you know, and you try and talk to them, and when that doesn't work, you just stop hanging around with them, and I can't do that with you. I can't just stop hanging around with my father.
I swear to you, buddy, it's over. It's over. I can be poor on welfare, but never again with this stuff. Never.
Can you do it? I mean, alone?
How about Mom, if you talk to her?
Hey, no, buddy, please. I don't think she knows yet. So let me try it alone, okay? Huh? And if it's too hard for me, I'll go for treatment. I swear to you, I promise.
Dad, I love you. I just want to help you.
Oh, you are, buddy. Oh, God, you are.
Stranger, you must have got my message. How'd the meeting go?
I want you to spot me one last hit to get through this.
Eddie, you let me down. What happened to the outs?
Fell in the toilet. Accident.
Everything?
Yeah.
You must have died. Look, I don't keep anything here.
Well, you must have a friend that I could call.
What the hell do you mean talking to me like that? I'm not some back alley dealer shooting up clients. Look, if you can't handle the Braylers, there's always Tad Voss.
Hey.
All right. Now, you're a little strung out. Tell you what I'll do. Call Jack. I'll tell him you had a showing and that you'll meet him tonight at 6. Huh. I'll be at Robin's after work. Meet me there.
Good.
Cost you $500.
$500? My bank closes in 10 minutes. I can't. I'll write you a check.
Eddie, you know me. Strictly cash and carry. Some of my people are very unreliable.
I'll give it to you tomorrow.
Eddie, it's policy. You must have some money laying around, somebody you can borrow from.
You gotta help me. I'm only asking you one last
Eddie,
time.
I just gave you a $1 million deal. I'll see you later.
Here, you're supposed to meet me.
Eddie, I want you to leave. Go on.
Well, wait a minute. What happened? What's wrong?
They arrested him. I was waiting for him in the parking lot, and they arrested him.
Who arrested him?
I warned him so many times. He was carrying almost an ounce.
Well, he's straight. He's a banker. He can't be arrested.
Oh, Eddie, don't be so stupid. Go look it up. Possession with the intent to sell is a federal offense. He can get up to 15 years in prison. He's going to jail. Bruce is going to prison. I mean, what did you think? It was a free ride?
Rob, I know this sounds crazy, but I need a little to get me over a rough spot. Can you lend me?
Eddie, I want you to go away.
Rob,
Eddie! Oh.
I'm not going to hurt you.
This is the biggest deal of my life. I gotta get through it. I need it one last time.
There isn't any.
There's gotta be somewhere out here, someplace.
Eddie.
I'll pay you back. I swear I will.
The guy flushed it down the toilet. Would you please go away? Eddie, go away. Eddie! No, please.
What did you do with it?
You're hurting me.
What did you do with it?
I threw it away.
Plastic bag.
Eddie, we wondered where you got to today.
How's that car? Wouldn't go. Wouldn't work. Expensive car like that, power goes dead. Wouldn't go. It's crazy.
Are you all right?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine. So what was it? Your mother, Jack? What was that?
Why don't you sit down?
Yeah, why don't you sit down?
Hey, I don't need to sit down. Why don't you sit down? I'm fine. You got a nice place here. What'd they get for a room like this? 100, 200?
Jack, why don't you see if Eddie would like a cup of coffee or something?
Yeah, sure. How about
that? What are we doing here? We're buying and selling. There's nothing out there. You got somebody watching?
Well, me.
What's going on out there? Why are they hiding?
I know who you're talking about. I know. You think I'm not good enough? Oh, it's over.
Jack, do something, please!
Oh, yes, Tony, we need an emergency ambulance. Tony, quickly!
Get this out now.
Yeah, I need the monitors. Come on, get the monitors.
Take the bottle. Those IV lines here. Now.
Pulse is present.
Let's hook this up to the wall, will you?
Pupils equal, unreactive. Neurologically, it looks good. Don't see that monitor yet.
Neurologically, it looks good. Take a respiratory
exam. Stimulus. You'll have to stay out of here, man. Would you come with me? What's the
pupils equal and reactive. Neurologically, looks good.
Dr. Ferguson. Was he in an accident?
I don't know. Nobody will tell me. Somebody call me from a hotel. Why won't somebody talk to me? Doctor.
You're the wife?
Yes.
Take 24 hours. The worst should pass.
What was it, a heart attack?
No, not a heart attack per se. The dose wasn't lethal, just stupidly massive. Too much causes apnea. It's like respiratory failure. Some people it happens to, others nothing. They all underestimate the drug. Who knows with cocaine?
What did you say?
Your husband shows symptoms of cocaine poisoning. From the looks of the septum he's been using a while. Frankly, I'm surprised he didn't know he was overdosing. He should have known better.
You're a liar. You're a damn lousy liar.
Look, I'm sorry. I lost my bedside manner 15 hours ago. This isn't my first OD tonight. He should be okay. His system just couldn't assimilate that much coke. He was lucky.
Dr. Wilson, please.
You related to him?
He's my father.
This was in his jacket when they brought him in. Doctor had no choice. He's required by law to report drug ODs. So he'll have to be taken and booked for evidence.
You better call him a lawyer. Sorry, kid.
You knew, didn't you? Why didn't you tell me? That night at the table, it wasn't your drugs, it was his.
I'm so ashamed.
Sorry, Dad. You'll be all right.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Don't try to talk, honey.
In light of your guilty plea, Mr. Gantz, no prior criminal record, I'm rescinding the term of 2 years to probation and a mandatory drug rehabilitation program. I'm also placing upon you a fine of $5,000. You will report to your probation officer twice a month and submit to a random year analysis. Any further involvement in drugs, and I'll remand you to the custody of the San Diego Police Department. Do you understand the court's order, Mr. Gant?
I do, Your Honor. Thank you. Thank you very much.
That's all, Mr. Gant.
Thought that I was doing anything that was bad until it was too late.
And I'm scared.
So am I. I just got lost. I thought I didn't believe in myself anymore. I just thought that I didn't matter. Forgive me.
Excuse me.
No, it's all right. Stay. I'm sorry, buddy.
It's okay, Dad.
I just want you to know that as I loved you, I love you both very much.